नमस्कार, आई एम सुबोजित पंडा फ्रॉम भुवनेश्वर। आई एम हियर टू स्पीक अ बिट अबाउट फार्मिंग एंड इट्स वेरियस एस्पेक्ट्स। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। द फ्रूट्स एंड ग्रीन वेजिटेबल्स दैट वी ऑल ईट एवरी डे कम फ्रॉम द फार्म्स। द फार्मर्स वर्क वेरी हार्ड टू फीड एन एंटायर कंट्री। बट डू यू नो, व्हाइल फार्मिंग इज कंसिडर्ड वन ऑफ द मोस्ट टफेस्ट प्रोफेशंस इन द वर्ल्ड, इट कैन बी quite lucrative and profitable one if done in the proper way. Yes, farming can be a lucrative and profitable one if done in the proper way. But the question is, if you have a land patch and are really passionate about farming, agriculture, growing crops, then how do you start? Where do you start from? Let me tell you then. First, it is very important to learn what farming is all about. You can start visiting small farms, gain knowledge about what farming is all about, and you can talk to farmers there. Second, you need to decide what kind of farming you're interested in. Whether you simply want to grow fruits and vegetables, or you're interested in poultry or dairy farming. Third, you might not have all the capital or money to start farming. For the same, you can approach a bank or any financial institution around you for loans to start farming. Now let's talk about the seasons or climate or weather. One of the most vital factors that decide the success rate of farming is climate or weather. If crops or farming is done according to the climate, then you're more likely to be successful in farming. There are few crops like rice, cotton, groundnut, jute, sugarcane, etc., whose seeds can be sown in between the months of May to July, and can be harvested during September or October. While there are few other crops that need a relatively cool climate for their growth, but warm climate for the germination of the seeds and maturation. Such crops include wheat, gram, potatoes, etc., which are mostly sown in between the months of October to December. Interestingly, there are few other crops like watermelon, cucumber, leafy and other vegetables which can be raised throughout the year. Yes, there are few crops, there are few food items that can be raised, that can be grown throughout the year. So first, you need to recognize the crops you are interested to grow, and then you can start sowing the seeds according to the suitable climate required for them to grow properly. Most of the time, we hear about hordes of fruits and vegetables produced getting wasted every year. Why? It's because of lack of proper rural infrastructure or godowns. Hence, it is important to properly store the fruits or vegetables produced. Farmers can use a portion of their home, or they can rent out a space around their house to store the produce. This can be a good idea. In fact, a group of farmers can together make efforts to store all the produce under one roof. I think this can be also a better idea. But the support of local administration in this regard is very important. The local administration has to come forward, support the farming community in this regard. There are few things that can be done to bring a lot of changes in the agricultural sector. Let's discuss about that. If farmers get an assured minimum support prices for their producers, then most of the farmers will be encouraged to put in lot of efforts to produce new crops and food items. There is a need to eliminate middle person. Yes, there is a need to eliminate middle person such that the goods or crops produced can be smoothly transferred from factories to farmers or from farmers to factories, vice versa. Interest-free or low interest credit should be given away to farmers through cooperative banks to boost their morale, to encourage them for farming. The functioning in trade should be made digital or online for the larger benefit of the farming community. Besides, Farming should be included as a special course in schools and colleges. This is very important. Farming should be included as a special course in schools and colleges to introduce the younger generation with the farming at a pretty young age. But apart from the traditional farming, let's not talk about the traditional farming of growing rice or, wheat. I will now suggest you a few new ideas related to farming. You can start your own kitchen garden or go for rooftop cultivation if you're really passionate about growing different types of fruits and vegetables using less capital. New farming techniques like vertical farming, aquaponics, or cellular agriculture should be promoted as they hold a lot of promise in terms of production and source of income. Now, when we are talking about new ideas, let me talk about a new farming technique or idea that not many of us have heard about before. Yes, I'm discussing about aquaponics. Aquaponics is a sustainable way, or it's a sustainable method of raising both fish and vegetables. So you can raise both fish and vegetables at a single go. So what aquaponics is all about? Aquaponics is a form of agriculture that combines raising fish in tanks, which is called aquaculture, with soil-less plant culture, which is called hydroponics. That's where the name has been derived from, that is aquaponics. In aquaponics, the nutrient-rich water from raising fish provides a natural fertilizer for the plants, and the plants help to purify the water for the fish. So aquaponics can be used to sustainably raise fresh fish and vegetables for a family, to feed a village, or to generate profit in a commercial farming venture. And this can be done, believe me, in any climate throughout the year. Aquaponics is a great example of year-round indoor farming. So it's a kind of indoor farming. It can be done literally anywhere, providing less local food, that is sorry, that is providing fresh food which is free of pesticides, herbicides, and chemical fertilizers. It is safe, easy, and fresh. And the best part about aquaponics is you don't use any chemicals. You don't use any pesticides here, otherwise the fishes would die. Since no pesticide or chemical is used, the rivers or lakes are protected. Aquaponics uses 90% less water than traditional farming. Water and nutrients are recycled in a closed loop fashion, which conserves water, providing nutrients and an oxygen-rich environment for the roots of aquaponics plants, makes them grow, you can't believe, 3 times faster as compared to soil. The fish you grow are free from pollution, unlike many sourced from the sea. This goes for the vegetables as well. And what happens, it remains as a system. That is the beauty about aquaponics. And an important benefit of an aquaponic system is that it produces fish and plants for the family all year round without leaving their backyard. So this is very good. A family will save time and fuel without having to shop for the same items, and also use more healthy herbs and veggies in their cooking and green smoothies. Aquaponics reduces erosion by eliminating the need to turn or plow the soil. You don't need to make use of the soil here. The backbreaking work of turning soil, plowing soil, and pulling weeds is all gone. Thereby, the cost, which is compared to a horticultural farm, is totally reduced here. Also, by growing in abandoned warehouses where you don't have any work, you don't use it, we are using these structures. Thereby, you save money, energy, and other valuable resources. The benefits of using an aquaponic system to grow food are becoming more important. Why? It's because of population growth, making fresh water very scarce and pollution more prevalent within the world. And I spoke about aquaponics. Last but not the least, let me speak a bit about Indian farming. Like Indian culture and tradition, agriculture or farming in India is highly multidimensional. India's ecological diversity, crop diversity and diet diversity are all interconnected. They symbiotically support each other. India is a multi-product agricultural powerhouse. No other country, trust me, no other country grows as many food and non-food crops as India. Agriculture is India's largest private sector that employs 54% of the country's total workforce of 481 million. It is this labor-intensive agricultural sector that has taken India to global glory. India has brought about a landmark agricultural revolution that has transformed the nation from chronic dependence on grain imports to a global agricultural powerhouse. Indian agriculture system is a model of sustainable agriculture for the whole world. So time has come to tap the potential that Indian farming, Indian agriculture has to offer. We have everything that can take Indian agriculture, Indian farming to new heights. All we need is support and cooperation from each and everyone in the society. Time has come to prove to the whole world that Indian agriculture was, is, and will always remain the best. So that was my presentation on farming, different aspects of farming. I spoke about a new farming technique, a new agriculture technique, which is aquaponics. And lastly, I spoke about Indian agriculture. I hope you all liked my presentation. Thank you for your patient hearing. Namaskar, this is Subhojit Panda signing off.